Fallout 3, Operation Anchorage. And this is Rebel Inc. This is our third video, yeah. So, here we're, in a second we're about to get the Gauss rifle. And again, that's the kind of special weapon that you get in this game. You know, the main special weapon. It's a really good gun. As I mentioned before, the ammo that it takes is actually that right there. Those MF cells, microfusion cells. And if you remember, if you have a plasma gun, they like every microfusion cell gives you like so many bullets. I'm thinking like maybe 20, 25. This one uses all of its the microfusion cell energy all at once to shoot one bullet. So, I'm gonna ready it in that slot, and then I'm gonna go ahead and show it. Excuse me, use it real quick here, just to kind of show you what it looks like if you haven't played this game yet. And you get to keep this gun as part of this cash game. You'll see that you get it. So, pretty much, it's a one-hitter quitter. You know, but I have shot this gun at regular Chinese soldier and not killed him in one shot, so I don't know. But for the most part, if you're in sneak mode and you're gonna do a critical attack, I highly doubt that you're not gonna get the one shot one kill. So yeah, so keep that in mind. Alright, now as I mentioned before, this is also intel guide. Here's your buddy follower,
I almost didn't make it.
Sergeant Montgomery.
Yeah.
So now he's gonna, for the rest of this mission, he's gonna be with you. And he's pretty competent. He doesn't do anything idiotic to really, you know, get in your way or whatnot. And then again, he doesn't do anything phenomenal to, you know, to take all the glory and shine away from you. So. You just, you know, your partner fodder. Anyways, so, just as I mentioned before, this is going to be an intel guide also. There's 10 intel pieces, that we're going to be retrieving. And I'm going to show you all the locations for them. And, for that, you're going to get the covert ops perk, which is, three bonus points added to, I'm going off the top of my head, your sneak skill, and a couple other things. Really, it's, I don't remember because there's nothing really to get too excited about, but you do get a perk called Covert Ops. And, somebody will probably post in the comments what you actually get, so if you know, feel free to do so. And then I'll probably put it on the annotation. So most of them are behind these locked doors. Now I don't know if it's because my lockpick is so high, or you know what the main deal is. But you can see it is 100% force lock to the right, and you get, like I mentioned before, you get 50 bobby pins continuously. They won't. You always have them, so it's like infinite bobby pin ammo, so don't worry about, again, having to look for anything. There's your first briefcase. Intel number 1 of 10. And, so yeah, with the door, if it says force lock 10, so you know, force lock 100%, why even bother trying to lock, you know, do the lockpick system? Just do the force pick, open the door, and get what you need and get out. So, now be careful on the pipe. Because I thought, you know, maybe there was an invisible wall. No. I fell off that thing a couple times. I'm trying to be, fancy. So. Now, I gotta say, the views on this game, man, are quite breathtaking. Not to say that I've been to Alaska, but man, this place looks pretty neat. Maybe one day one of our Alaskan viewers can reveal this is geographically accurate representation of, so you're gonna see me here do a lot, because especially with the soldiers, they're so, their camouflage is so good that sometimes you can't spot them right away. I'll hit the VAT system, find them, and then go out of the VAT system, you know, not move your gun at all, and then shoot, you know, zoomed in, and you will hit them. I mean, as long as your accuracy is good, you know, you'll hit them. But, that's a system that works pretty well. So, just continue to get it. You see here, this is where it's funny, because, you know, I'm just taking out everybody with just one shot, and I'm telling you, man, it just gets ridiculous with that. Really for perk. Okay. So here is intel number 2. Of 10. Be found. And now if you're an achievement hunter, there's 4 achievements in this game. And finding the intel is not one of them. You would think it would be one of them, but it's not. Again, the only thing you get is that covert ops perk. The achievements are just beating the levels. Like, so for example, this one is Operation. Obviously, the game's called Operation Anchorage, but if I'm not mistaken, the first level is called Operation Anchorage as well. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Just if you beat the game, you'll get your 4 achievements that you're gonna be looking for. So pretty easy to get those. Oh yeah, I had a comment. This guy, I can't remember off the top of my head, what his name was. Sorry, I forgot. But he asked what difficulty I was playing in. So here's a premise for all my walkthroughs. If you get an achievement for beating a game on a very hard difficulty, I will do it. Because obviously it serves a purpose, right? People want that achievement, or, you know, people need assistance and technique, strategy, etc. on how to beat their levels. Alright, that said, if there isn't an achievement, why torture yourself? You can put this game on hard if you want to. By all means, feel free to. This isn't a challenge. You know, knock yourself out. Put it on the harder setting. But I won't, because it doesn't serve a purpose for me. So with that said, I'm playing on it. So now if they made an update to where you do get achievements, then by all means, I'm all over it. I will be the first to make videos to talk about Fallout 3 hard setting strategies. So yeah, just keep that in mind. Anyways, this is the end of the third video. The next one, we're gonna be going inside and dealing with those freaking ninjas, man. They'll drive you fucking nuts. The dragon ninjas. So we'll see you in video 3. 4.